After escaping a mysterious fog, his compass useless, Bruce Gernon radios for help and discovers that he's over Miami, having travelled 160 kilometres in just 3 minutes. That means he would have been flying at over 3,000 kilometres per hour in a plane with a top speed of only 300 kilometres per hour. Could the physical location itself lead to the explanation? Meteorology professor David Perez believes it is the area that is key because of the powerful storms that originate there.
About 87% of these missing aircraft had the same similar weather phenomena when they went down. And this was between a high and low pressure system over Florida, and that it was a zone of transition.
These zones create massive thunderstorms with rain and lightning. But Professor Perez believes there is more to it than that. Huge amounts of the Earth's electrical energy is harnessed in thunderstorms. A storm's electrical energy breaks air molecules apart into positive and negative ions. Perez believes the ionized air affected Gernon's compass.
This is an actual aircraft compass. And now we'll introduce a small coil with a battery attached. The coil generates its own electromagnetic field. When I take this coil field from the battery and introduce this, we see is that there's total deflection here.
Deflection of a compass is one thing, but Gernon's compass wasn't just deflected, it was spinning.
And as we manipulate this around, we can induce the spin, and this is exactly what we see inside the aircraft in the event of an electronic fog.
Enter the electronic fog created by the overwhelming power of the ionized air.
The ionized particles will come up the exhaust stacks of the airplane and adhere around the aircraft, knock out the instruments, prevent the pilot from seeing out of the windscreens because the fields are locked around the airplane.
This electrical energy may explain the fog that engulfed Gernon's plane. But how could it explain the speed with which he traveled? Could it be a space warp?
To visualize local space warp, let's put a piece of paper up onto our screen. Point A, point B. Now let's take the piece of paper and now fold it. And now we're crossing point A to B, but obviously it's a far less distance to cross to these two points as it is with the paper stretched out. And this essentially is what space warp is about, the compression of the fabric of space.
Though considered science fiction, not science fact, theoretical physicist Miguel Alcubierre postulates that with enough energy, one can do the impossible and travel faster than the speed of light as space warps back into itself. Einstein said that nothing can go faster than the speed of light, but then scientists discovered dark energy, a mysterious cosmic force that can be used to explain the inexplicable. Like gravity, dark energy is a force, but it pushes instead of pulls. It's a theoretical force that has real cosmic effects.
Cubierre proposed that if you could create this bubble around a ship where the dark energy is artificially increased behind, space-time expands, you artificially cause the dark energy to become negative in front of the ship, space-time starts collapsing in front. So you have a push behind and a pull in front. And the person in his ship is like riding this spatial wave forward.
This controversial theory also explains Gernon's plane being lost on radar, landing with more fuel than expected, and of course, flying much faster than its capabilities.